For those of you wondering why I would put salt into a bathtub, then you probably don't know much about today's movie then, don't you? Well, today we are reviewing a very special movie. It's a movie that I love and I've watched forever. Today's movie is none other than Splash. 1984 movie starring Tom Hanks. Why are we doing a Tom Hanks movie? Well, that is a wonderful question, sir. Because it's Tom Hanks month right here on the Movie Guys 101. That's right, children, we're going to be reviewing Tom Hanks movies all throughout the merry month of May. And it's going to be wonderful. B-E-A-utiful. Alright, so, let's get started with our first installment. This is one of the earliest Tom Hanks entries on our list, and it's a very great early entry. This movie stars Tom Hanks, Darryl Hannah, John Candy, and Eugene Levy. That's right, all in one movie. And it's a great cast. You know, so many people turned it down, you know, before Tom Hanks, before Darryl Hannah, but it turned out awesome. Tom Hanks was really awesome in this. So the storyline is this. Alan is a very young boy in the 1960s. You know, in the opening scene, he's on a boat at Cape Cod. Randomly, he jumps into the water. And, you know, he's underwater and everything, and people think he's gone overboard. Oh my gosh! But then a little mermaid, same age as, you know, this young boy is, rescues him, brings him to safety. Flash forward 20 years, Alan is now a successful business person running a fruit company. Very nice fruit company, distribute fruit to all different supermarkets across New York. It's in New York City. His wife / girlfriend, I forget which, leaves him, empties the house, etc. And so he thinks that he'll never find the right woman again. Now, in a drunken stupor, you know, he goes to the bar with his brother, Freddie, who is played by John Candy. They go to a bar, Alan gets drunk, and goes in a cab to Cape Cod. And interestingly enough, he goes on this little boat, falls overboard, and he gets rescued again by the same mermaid, and he briefly meets this mermaid, not knowing who she is, not knowing that she's actually a mermaid. Now, of course, they both go their separate ways, but the mermaid, Madison, finds Alan's wallet. And of course, you know, looking through his wallet, she figures out that he lives in New York City. So, she tracks him down in New York City, they meet, they instantly fall in love, and it's a great relationship except for an antagonist, and that's Eugene Levy, who plays a professor. Very studious person. He is trying to prove that Madison is a mermaid. And he has tried and tried and tried and tried. He tries to prove that she's a mermaid by getting her legs wet. And it offers some really great comedy of him trying to do this. And, you know, government gets involved, blah, 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 blah. But it's a really feel-good story. I won't ruin the end for you, but it's a really great story. Really great comedy. There's got some drama, action. It's an everything movie. And yes, there's romance, but it's not the stereotypical romantic film, you know. But people who like romantic movies, they'll like this film. But this is definitely more mainstream. It's not really geared towards romantic film audiences, but it's great! And come on, it's directed by Ron Howard, Tom Hanks, John Candy, Eugene Levy in the same film. You gotta love it. And the underwater cinematography in this film is another notable thing about it. It's really spectacular to look at, you know, seeing, you know, mermaid, you know, swimming through the ocean underwater, you know, going through a shipwreck. It's great. That's great stuff. Great cinematography, great storyline, great scenes, great comedy. Oh my gosh. Do I have to convince you anymore? You know, my reputation on the Movie Guys 101 is I'm very kind to films that I like. And I would most definitely have to give this a 4.9. Yes, a 4.9. Gotta change it up a little. There is one problem with this film, and the only problem I see is that we never get to see the ex-wife. Whether she's important to the story, you know, is not really important, but I think it would have been interesting to see her as a secondary antagonist in this film. I think that would have been somewhat interesting. It's like, what? I left you and now you're dating a mermaid? What? But it's a great film. Good laughs. You'll love it. Go watch it. You can borrow my VHS copy if you want. Spectacular. Alright. Whether I'll post something on Rotten Tomatoes or not, that's a maybe. I'm kind of lazy, so if I do post something, I'll post a link below on Rotten Tomatoes. But you can find me on Rotten Tomatoes. Friend me, whatever. Yeah, that's great. I won't read your messages because people, like, spam me a lot with BS. And I don't really want to read a bunch of BS. So, be sure to subscribe to the Movie Guys 101 right here on YouTube. And for our full list of Tom Hanks movies that we'll be doing this month, go to the Movie Guys 101 channel, look in the channel description. There'll be a whole list for you of the films that we're going to be reviewing and who's going to be reviewing them. Some of them will be group collaborations. In fact, I'm actually doing a movie review with Mark. We're going to be reviewing Apollo 13, so that's going to be very fun. That's going to be coming up on Wednesday. We'll try to release it by Thursday or Friday or sometime after Wednesday. We'll work that out. Alright, I'm Joey Trask, and I'll see you later for the Movie Guys 101. Splash! Get it?